All right, someone says it. I can't pay. Years ago, someone said, I can't afford to pay my tithes. I told myself I cannot afford not to.
That's it.
And so my testimony is just about the awesomeness of God. And just sometimes we have to be patient when we expect God to show up. And so at my current position, my job, some of you all know I work, hired me, quote unquote, on a certain level. But then when I saw my checks, it was on another level. And how many, you know, sometimes when your money is a little short, even Christians cuss. I don't cuss, but, you know, some of y'all do. I heard you. But anyway, I was patient, and I waited patiently, and I inquired. And sometimes people tell you they're going to do something, and so they don't do it, right? And so I was a little frustrated. And then sometimes, how many know that the flesh takes over? And so we have that sometimes that attitude, well, if they're not going to pay me what they said, I'm not going to do everything I'm supposed to. Somebody can be honest with you. Two hands. Yeah, I know I'm telling the truth. But anyway, God began to speak to my heart. And he said, begin to work as unto the Lord and not unto man. And so I took that disposition, and I just began to work, and I began to just to do what I was supposed to do, encouraging people, doing above and beyond. I still would check. I still made my inquiries. Faith without works is dead. To make a long story short, it had been 6 months, so I've been short on my check. A lot of money for 6 months. And so Thursday, I was actually doing something. I had talked to the county director. She said, come to my office. She said, I'm so sorry. She said, you haven't told your mama that I've been slow on doing this. I said, oh, no. But I said, yeah, in my head, I told her, mama. But anyway, make a long story short, in the multitude of business, I was doing some work on the floor, and the assistant county director, he said, I was talking to some people. He said, hey, man, I need to see you in my office. So they was like, oh, you're in trouble now. I said, man, what's that? So I went to him. He said, hey, what you need to do is go get them applications real quick, fill out a P-12, and go down to the human resources right now. I said, all right. I said, what's a P-12? He said, go online and find it. Make a long story short, I did what I was supposed to do. The position came open, and so they're going to keep me in my same department. Everything is still going to be the same, except my increase will be there. So I thank God for his faithfulness. And just like Brother Curtis said, you can't be God-given. And so anything that leads your hand never leads your life. So as you begin to sow into the work of the Lord, how do you know that God wants his kingdom established? So if he can get money into your hand, if he can trust you, he's like, well, the more money I get into Brother Derek's hand, the more money I'm going to have in my ministry to spread the gospel. So when you begin to give, think about that. Not like, ooh, I got this last $25 and I'm hungry. Well, hey, God got your back. All right. So that's all I want to tell you. God got your back. God bless you. And Brother Williams, are you waiting for that? Are you waiting? You got a question? No. I was just in my class at school. A lady raised a hand like that when she was doing a sermon. And so the girl was nervous. She said, "You got a question?" Well, I was nervous. All right. Amen.